the year was 1899. This was the time of the Boer Wars between Great Britain and the free independent Boer states. The place is Mafeking, South Africa. Now, the British commander of Mafeking is Robert Stevenson, a very distinguished soldier who had served in the Zulu Wars, served in India, and had a very successful military career because he was a planner and an organizer. One of the first things he had to do, and this is a history lesson for some of us, is the Boers created the term commando, the quick, hard-hitting raids, and they were hitting commando raids on the British supply trains. So Robert Stevenson started to stockpile supplies and stockpile supplies, and he started organizing local troops in case there was an attack. And the attack came. For 217 days, the Boers attacked Mafeking. For 217 days, Robert Stevenson had to organize and defend Mafeking. And the cannons shot, and the soldiers fired. And the cannons shot, and the soldiers fired. And for 217 days, it looked like there was a stalemate. And as happens in any siege, when the cannons are firing, there's scrap metal and unexploded bombs. And the buildings are damaged and looks like they're gonna fall. And as with any siege, the young boys in the town, not much older than Avery, are running around picking up scrap metal and exploring these damaged buildings that can fall. So now, Robert Stevenson had two problems. How to keep the town safe from the Boers, and how to keep the boys safe from themselves. But he was an organizer. So he called in his chief of staff and said in his great military British tone, "Major, we must do something to organize these boys to make sure that they are successful and useful to the defense of Mafeking." And you see, he's been a professional soldier. He doesn't know much about young boys, 11 to 15. So his chief of staff organized Mafeking cadets into squads. And this squad of boys was serving in the hospital, and this squad of boys was serving in the mess hall so the soldiers could go out on the front lines. And he had a squad that was working with communications, running the messages to the outposts, using donkeys until they had to start chopping up the donkeys for food. And then they used bicycles. And Robert Stevenson was really impressed that these boys were actually learning and having fun, but having fun with a purpose. And he said to one boy as he was riding his bike, he said, "Lad, tell me, are you not scared when the cannons fire?" And the boy looked up for him and said, "Blimey, no sir. When the cannons fire, I just pedal my bike faster." For 217 days, the Mafeking cadets helped save the town of Mafeking. At the end of the siege, the relief column came in, and Robert Stevenson was acknowledged as the hero Mafeking. He was sent back to Great Britain, and he was promoted to general. Matter of fact, some of you may know him by his full name, General Robert Stevenson Smythe, Lord Baden-Powell. Yes, Baden-Powell that founded the scouting movement. 217 days of Mafeking gave him the inspiration that young boys could do more, and the scouting movement was founded. Has the scouting movement changed the world? I challenge you. See, I tell this story because I was a scoutmaster, and I would tell that at campfires, and I would challenge the new boys. I said, "Can you live up to the legacy of the Mafeking cadets and learn new skills, take accountability, and help out your community?" But more importantly, I challenge the leaders, the adults or you as community leaders. Imagine the environment that Robert Stevenson, Lord Baden-Powell, his chief of staff, had to give to these young boys to get them engaged. See, I'm a believer in what D.F. Skinner, the behavioralist, said. People will live up and behave to your expectations. They can be very sanguine in their performance because of your performance as a leader. As a scoutmaster, I was being recruited. This is before I became scoutmaster. I was an assistant to an assistant, but they said, this guy knows something about people. And we were on a camp out, and I was in charge, and we had a young boy, we had a boy that was hurt, so he wasn't going to go on the hike. So I left his patrol, four boys, back in camp. And I said to them, I said, will you be ready to teach the new first-year scouts campfire building? And the boys looked at me, eyes got big, and said, Mr. Nickel, we get to teach? We get to work with the axe and saw and teach fire building? I said to myself, maybe the adults have been doing too much of the work that the boys could be doing. Fun with a purpose. That same camp out, we were going on a hike. Remember I said we're going on a hike? Right, Joe? Scouts do hiking. Head nods are good right about now. And I called the senior boy aside, Ryan Skaggs, great Eagle Scout, great family. And I said, Ryan, I said, what's your magic number? He goes, sir. I said, that's my Marine Corps training coming out. Accountability of people. So what's your magic number? How many scouts do you have on this hike? He looked at me, and I could see it was in his head. He wanted to say, Mr. Nickel, why the heck are you asking me? You adults have always counted noses. So I let him off the hook. I said, you're in charge of the scouts. You're going to set the pace, pair them up, give the safety brief. I'm in charge of the adults. The adults will hike at the back of the troop. It's your program. And he said, got it. And he gave them a great safety brief. He taught them things about the woods. Some of our adults said, I didn't know that. And the boys, once again, just a little bit older than Avery, said, wow, this is neat. The older boys, because these were really old boys. They were 16 and could shave and drive cars and all that. So the 11-year boys listened to them more than they wanted to listen to the adults. People will perform to the way you expect them to. Does the scouting movement change the world? Ask some Eagle Scouts. Ask Senator Bill Bradley from New York. Ask businessman J. Willard Marriott, H. Ross Perot, Neil Armstrong, first man on the moon, even President Gerald Ford, all Eagle Scouts. Does scouting change the world? I got a note from a college student over in K-State, and he said, Mr. Nickel, I just wanted to let you know I just got elected to be president of my fraternity. I didn't run for it. I was nominated from the floor, and I ran against boys who had some more experience. But thanks to the leadership lessons, the accountability that you taught me in Troop 92, I am the president of my fraternity. The path I'm on today is because of what scouting gave me. Thank you, and thanks, scouting. Madam Joseph.